I think I do sustain the myself because I've been raised by the nation, not by just my mother. So most of people come here because they want to be celebrated. They come here because they want to be something that they don't even know themselves, what they do they want to be. But when you come to the industry, it's because it's a calling. You have to respect the people, you have to respect the producers, the directors, the writers, the scriptwriters, everybody, the continuity lady, because they all have their job to do. But when you come here, you think that me, I'm just going to listen to the director, then I'm not going to listen to you, then you've got a problem, you're not going to last in this industry. In this industry is very small. When you come here, you don't do your job, you don't read your lines, you come here late, you don't disrespect other people, it's alcohol, it's promiscuity, all those things. You are in a wrong position. You have to get something else. But here you have to like respect yourself, respect the others, do your job, and know why you're here. Because this job is a calling. If it's not your calling, don't think that your pretty face will work for you, or your because you know somebody else. It's not about knowing somebody else. It's not like affection that you can say, "Hey, you can't find him. You cannot find him," because you have your work will talk for itself. So as an artist, you have to understand those things. To be honest with Pepper, it was like I had to wear high heels every day, and the soil was so soft, and then you have to be on your toes all the time, and then you have to run round the crop and be fighting with other women, those other four women. So we're fighting for one man. So those were the things that we used to, when I'm thinking of wearing high heels. I felt like sometimes I just want to walk barefoot, you know, do whatever the rural people are doing. But I had to wear heels. Those were the things that annoyed me. But otherwise, I enjoyed each and every part I remember from the day I came in up to today. I still remember what happened to that set. We are growing, but we don't understand why are we growing. We just grow. You find yourself someone else earning so much money, you don't even know why. Am I being paid this amount of money? This industry, we have to work hard. We have to work so hard to achieve all those things you work hard in. Doesn't take you 2 years, then you are there, you are a superstar, you are a celebrity. After 2 years, then it's gonna fall. There are few people who are lucky. Some other people are lucky to be there, and then boom, they happen. But most of them, it's not like that. So you have to work hard, and don't give up, because it's not easy. There's no business, actual business. I don't think that there is anything, because I was fortunate enough, because they threw me into this deep end. They wanted me to do it. I didn't want to do it, because I knew that I'm a dancer. I was a dancer. So I didn't want to be an actress, because acting, I have to read the lines and memorize them, and then act. I didn't want to do all those things, because I do them every day of my life. And they said, "Thembi, we've got a part for you. We want you to do this part." And I didn't want to, but because I wanted to prove them wrong and prove myself wrong, I went and do the show. That's when I did Deliwe. I started with Deliwe. And then secondly, I came with Mfazwe Pepe. And I did so well, and I didn't want to do Mfazwe Pepe, period. But a person who was doing that show died. And everybody suggested Thembi can do the part. Because I'm always acting behind the scenes, not knowing that I can act on television. So they threw me in, and I said, "Okay, you believe in me?" And I have to believe in myself. Then I started believing in myself. And I pushed myself, and I went so hard, because I had script that I've never seen before, about 7 dialogues. I said, "Me? I'm going to read all this and then come in, act it." They said, "Yes, we're going to do it." I'm like, "My God, I have to." And I had to, because my parents didn't want me to be in show business. They wanted me to be a social worker. And I didn't want to be a social worker, because I was a social worker in real life. You know, helping people, not knowing that I'm a social worker. In my community, like I said, I've been raised by so many mothers. Everybody was like, "Thembi, don't do this." And I'll listen and take that. Thembi, don't do that. Thembi, ah, good. And I enjoyed that. So my mother wanted me to be a social worker, but that was not me. I said, okay, I'm going to follow this route. I'll be an actor, I'll be a dancer. Because dancing was the only thing that kept me sane. Because I was out of control. When you're out of control, you know, because something is inside you, and then you want to do it, and your parents don't even understand it. You don't even know how to explain to them that I'm burning inside me. I'm burning to be on stage. And when they allowed me to be on stage, that's when everything happened, and I never looked back.
Thank you so much, Ba. Thank you.
Thank you very much.